Happy day, students. As we all know, we have been discussing a lot of topics under the subject elements of film studies in our semester. And today we are going to be discussing about the various stages of film production. That is going to be the topic of discussion today. So today we are going to start with what are the stages that go behind the production of filmmaking. So we all know we love films, we watch films a lot on screens, on theatres, or nowadays because of the COVID situation we have been watching it on television screens at home theatres and our OTT platforms. But we are not sure of what exactly goes behind the making or the production process of filmmaking. So even though we disregard a film as being good or bad at a very first watch or anything, but what happens actually behind the process is quite tedious and cumbersome. And as media students, you must get to know what are the different stages of the filmmaking process, which we are going to be discussing today. So let's move on. So the various stages of film production we can classify generally into three broad categories: pre-production, production and post-production, which any television production will also be teaching you on that. But in film production we go a little bit elaborate because it is a quite a tedious process and it's quite time consuming, and we have divided it into five broad categories. We have the development stage, the pre-production stage, the production stage, the post-production stage, followed by the distribution stage. Because filmmaking is, unlike television production, a much more complicated process, so we are going to be dealing it with in detail, and we are going to see what are the various processes that go into each of these categories of stages of the filmmaking process. So let's start with the first one, the developmental stage. So in the developmental stage of filmmaking, before even the actual scripting process or the writing process of filmmaking, we have something called as the development stage. Usually we all are aware that the filmmaking process starts from the idea of the director or the person who is going to create the story for the film. So this is where the development process comes into practice. The first initial or the most fundamental stage of the developmental process is the ideation process. Usually any great film will start with the idea from a particular person, of maybe a director or a writer or a producer or an actor or anybody else. So basically it starts with the first process, which is the ideation process. So in the ideation process, any person or a group of persons, like a brainstorming session could happen, and they would come up with an idea which will take final shape of a film. So in the ideation process, this is what happens. They come up with an idea about, like, say they come across a particular piece of information from the news which they happened to watch yesterday. From that, they could have picked up an idea of making a biopic about a particular person, or somebody could have been recently passed away or anything, like say Dilip Kumar passed away recently. So what happens, you can get an idea of making a biography on the, or a biopic on Dilip Kumar itself. So like that, you get some ideas from everywhere, and once the idea is formed, you have to develop it into a script. That happens during the ideation process. Then comes the story developmental stage. Once the idea takes shape, once the proper idea is arrived at, from there you will have to derive to a proper story. Story is what makes the script. That is what is going to be broken down into the script stage of filmmaking. So once the idea is formed, then the group of people sit together, or one person sits and brainstorms himself to come up with a story, because filmmaking is a fiction medium. It is not a non-fiction medium, unlike a documentary where you can just put in things together, facts together, and present it and compile it together. It is not like that. So filmmaking is a fiction process. It's a fiction film or a feature film that you're going to make. So what you're going to do is, once the idea is arrived at, you start developing a story around the idea process, so that you have a proper story from the start to the finish, like a proper narrative, which will be converted into the final stages of the scripting process. Then, once the story and, say, let's say a speculative script, the story script is ready. So with that, the filmmaking process will not, straight away get into the actual shooting process or anything. It has to go through another important phase, which is where the director or the person who writes the script or the story has to go and approach a producer, where the producer will have to give the funding process, because without funds you cannot make a film. Filmmaking is an expensive process too. So once the story is developed, you have to actually get in touch with a producer or a person, a financier, who is giving you the green signal for you to start the production process of the filmmaking. So till that, we have in the developmental stage. Okay, so let's see what happens after the developmental stage. Okay, then we move on to another stage called as a pre-production stage, which is very, very, very important stage in the filmmaking process. Usually what people say is, the more time you devote to the pre-production stage, the better, and the less time that you will consumed during the production and the post-production stage. Because once you properly plan out everything, then it becomes much more easier during the production as well as during the post-production stage. So pre-production is all about the processes that go before the actual or the principal cinematography or the shooting of the film. So once your producer is ready, you have to develop something called as a script. The script is what is the major document which everybody will get back to or refer to in order for the production of the film. So the script is generally made ready, and the story which you have is given a treatment or a screenplay is given to it, and a proper, because cinema demands a certain structure or a way in which the story can be presented to the audience in an interesting way, because it needs to hook the audience till the end of the film. So the screenplay is done and a proper script is arrived at, which will be the document which everybody will be having in their hands, which they will refer back to. And you have something called as a storyboard. Now, storyboard is something which makes your shooting process much more easier, and it is very, very helpful for the art director or the cinematographer, because your exact frame, what you're going to capture in the camera through the camera lens, is going to be properly structured, and the shot divisions and the detailing of the shots, whether it is a mid shot or a long shot, whatever details you want to include in the shot, the camera movements and everything is included in the storyboard, so that it becomes much more easier for the cinematographer to shoot the film as well as the editor to edit the film in the post-production stage. So once the storyboard is ready, it is nothing but a pictorial representation of each and every shot and scene in the film. So once the storyboard is ready, we can be more sure of what exactly we are going to film and what your visual is going to look like when you finally shoot it and present it for the screen. So after the storyboard, we move on to the next process of the filmmaking in the pre-production stage, whereby you are selecting the manpower that is required for the production of the film. So first you have to go to a process called as casting. By casting, we mean the selection of the people who are going to act in your film. Like say the major male actor or the female actor, the heroine or the villain or the comedian or the major actors in your film will be selected. And usually there's a person called as a casting director who helps you to select out the right person for the right kind of role that is being played by the actor for the exact film that you're going to shoot. So once the casting process is done, you have all your actors ready for you to start the filming. Then we select the crew. By crew, we mean the people who are involved technically in the making process of the film, like the cameraman or the cinematographer, the director of photography, as you call it in film techniques, or the editor or the music director or the choreographer, the stunt director, all these people, the art director, these are the key people who are in the filmmaking process, and they are also selected because the selection of each and every person makes a big difference in the final film. So the crew members are also selected after discussion with the producer, of course, because each and every person has a price to be paid to. So that has also been consulted with the producer, and the crew members are also finally selected for the film. Then you have something called as recce or the location shooting process. What happens is, if you are planning on a certain location in a specific way to be filmed in your movie, then you generally go to that particular place beforehand and test, do a pilot shooting or a test shooting. So this helps you to do the actual shooting much more efficiently and with much more ease and confidence. So that process also happens during the pre-production stage. That is what I mean by pilot shoot. So pilot shoot is nothing but a test shoot or a test run of your project in a very, like, you know, a minimal camera like a DSLR or maybe through your mobile phone itself, that can be done. The principle before the actual filming of the movie starts, you can do a pilot shoot or a test shoot. Then we have the music recording process, which also starts much earlier because audio tracks are released before the film itself is released. So the music production also starts. The music director starts his job and does the songs or the you know, the major incidents or situations where the song is going to be played. So the song recording process also starts much before the film is actually being shot. Then you have something called as set construction, where if you have a, like say you're doing a period film or something, you need a big palace setup or anything, you have to develop or build a proper set. The construction of the set takes time. So you can't arrive at the set construction on the day of the shoot. So you have to start much more earlier. So if your shoot is planned for next month, if your set construction takes at least a month's time, then you have to start much ahead. So the construction of the set and all the art direction department also is put into work. Then comes your scheduling. Scheduling is actual day-to-day scheduling or nothing but a shooting schedule of the entire shooting or the principal photographic process. So day by day, the schedule is broken down, the script is broken down, and you do a proper scheduling of day-to-day events and day-to-day scenes that are to be shot in a particular day. You have the You have to make a list of all the equipments, the call sheets, the timing, and all these logistics have to be maintained. All of this will happen during the exact planning for the shooting process will happen in the pre-production stage. And finally, any legal contracts like, you know, with the actors or with the producers or not revealing the story of the film or not moving away from the film at a later stage, all these kinds of legal contracts and bondages will also be signed much during the pre-production stage itself. So what happens next? Now everything is ready, planned and kept. Now what are we going to do next is what we are going to see now. Now that everything is planned and set, after the pre-production, we go into the next stage of filmmaking, which is called as the production stage, and let's see what happens during the production stage. So yes, the production stage is one of the most important stages of filmmaking because this is where a lot of money and the producer's finances get spent. Because here, once the shooting process begins, it is very difficult to call off the shooting or to postpone or to cancel the shooting because it involves a lot of people, a lot of money and a lot of equipments and other things to be coordinated into one place at one time. So the shooting process is a very expensive process of the filmmaking steps, and here is where you have to take the utmost care to minimize the cost and to minimize the time that is consumed for the actual production or the shooting process. So the principal cinematography or the principal filming or the shooting process of the film takes place during the production stage. Now that we have planned everything properly in the pre-production stage itself, the shooting process should be comparatively much more easier because we have everything planned and kept already. Then comes the spot sound. As you all know, in the filmmaking process, sound is recorded separately, unlike television, where film and the visual and the sound gets recorded together. So in the production stage, the sound department will work on the soundtrack, and that is also recorded as a low quality or not a very high grade quality of sound. That will be properly synced and replaced with the dubbing track in the post-production process. Yes, once the shooting is in progress, the soundtrack of the film will also be will be recorded onto a separate department. The sound department will usually take care of the soundtrack of the film, and that is recorded onto a digital audio tape or anything, which will be replaced by a final dubbed audio track in the later stages of the filmmaking process. So the art direction department, the direction department, the costumes, the makeup, the choreography, the catering, all these departments are found to work very in full force, or this is the most happening stage of the filmmaking process, because you see that all the departments, all these departments are in full force, acting in full swing, because the production process is much complicated and lot of departments will have to coordinate, like the food, the costumes, the makeup. If there is a song shooting happening, then the choreographers and all the dancers will be there, and if there is a stunt scene that is being filmed, then the stunt choreographer will be there. All these people will work in together in unison, and all the recording process, the filming process of the movie will take place in the production stage. So the direction department will be in full force or in full swing, and most of the assistant directors who help out, the ADs who help out the director, will be mostly involved, and their contribution is much more when compared to the other people, because they are the ones who coordinate all the call sheets of the artists, the logistics of the various departments together, and the production process will happen, which ends with the entire film being shot completely. Then we move on to the next stage of the filmmaking process, which is the post-production. After the film is being shot, the film does not end there. The making of the film does not end there. There are lots of other departments which are also involved in the filmmaking process, and they are fully active during the post-production stage. So firstly, once the film is shot, the cinematographer will have to be aware of what color output the film has to look like. So the color grading or the DI process of the filmmaking will happen during the post-production stage. Then we have the most important component of the post-production stage, which is the editing process. In the editing process, all the unwanted shots are removed and the good shots are assembled together, and the editor, in discussion with the director or the cinematographer, they will consult and sit through a lot of sessions in order to bring revised or better versions of the edited film. And you have the dubbing process, because during the shooting process or during the production stage, the soundtrack that is recorded may not be of a greater quality because of the lot of ambient noises which occur in the shooting spot. So in order to replace that with a proper clear sound that you get to listen on the cinema theaters, we need a proper sound which is recorded in a proper acoustically treated sound studio. So you do something called as ADR, automated dialogue replacement, also called as dubbing very commonly. This is where the actors will go to the studios, replace the existing noise soundtrack with a good soundtrack with proper dialogues in lip sync. So the dubbing process and all the other sounds, like, you know, breaking of a glass or all the Foley sounds, are also added and mixed along with the final output of the film, which is edited together. You have the re-recording process, or it's also called as a background music scoring process, which also happens during the post-production. The music director's job is not only to compose the songs of the film, they also do the BGM scoring for the film. So once the film is edited, almost kind of a final cut is arrived at, then the music director will sit for the post-production process, which is the background music scoring, where he looks at the edited film and composes the background music score for the film. So he usually operates in two stages, once before the film actually begins to shoot for the recording of the songs, and after the film is shot and edited for the background music scoring. Then finally, once all these soundtracks are recorded, then comes the job of the audio mixer or the sound mixing process. In this process, what happens is all these tracks are leveled out and placed at proper levels and placed properly in their appropriate places so that they are good to hear on the screen. That is called as audio mixing, which is the final audio mastering that happens during the post-production stage. If there are any special effects, like, you know, you want the you want a train to explode or meet with an accident in a film, you cannot create it live because it costs you a lot of money to make a train or to set up a train as if it is being met as if it is met with an accident. You can might as well create it in the computer graphical interface, which is much more simple, cost effective, and it does not involve any casualty. So that happens during the post-production stage, where all your special effects, all your visual effects, if there is any you know, graphical violent scenes that have to be included, or any magical effects or trick works need to be done, all that is done during the post-production. Your special effects, if there are any graphics or animation that has to be included, that is also done during the post-production stage. If your film is an entirely animated film, then your production process involves only the shooting of, you know, motion capture or anything, and most of the work is carried out in the post-production stage. If you happen to make any mistakes, or you need some extra footage in order to cover up or patch up the existing edited footage, then you might as well go for a reshoot of a certain number of scenes, or a certain particular shot alone, or a particular take, whatever you require, you can go for a reshoot. So with that, we come to the close of the post-production, where the film is almost ready, the final cut of the film is arrived at, with all the special effects, with all the proper soundtrack and everything is arrived at, and we have almost come to the close of the finish of the film, which is the post-production stage. There it ends. But is that the end of the filmmaking process? No, we have another step to go for the film to be seen by the public or the audience. Let's see what that is. In the post-production, we move on to something called as the final stage, where the distribution happens and the film hits the theaters for the audience or the public to see. With post-production getting over, we don't get to watch the film, because audience, before the film reaches the audience, there are other processes or other steps which need to be taken care of for the release of the film. So the censorship is one major aspect, because in India, any theatrical release of a film cannot happen without getting censorship certificate. So once the film is edited and all the final print is made ready, it has to be sent to the censor board for approval, and they will give a censorship certificate. That has to be attached in the beginning of the film, and only with that you can release the film for public viewing or public screening. Then you have previews. Now that the pandemic situation has been favorable to the audience, because they are able to sit at the comfort of their homes and watch everything on OTT platforms. But generally what happens is, the preview show, a distributor has to be invited in order to get the distribution rights for the film. So the person who produces the film will generally have a preview screening for the film and invite a lot of distributors and other producers who will buy the distribution rights of the film in order to exhibit them in their localities or in their regions. So the distributors will come and see the preview show, and they usually discuss packages. Like, you know, some people, if they like the film entirely, they will buy the outright purchase of the film. All the profits that come arise out of the film release and the exhibition will go to the distributor itself. Or sometimes it can be a sharing basis, like, you know, a certain percentage will go to the principal producer and a certain percentage will go to the distributor. The packages will be decided by the distributors and the producers, and sometimes there can be mergers. They can have a collaborative venture where they can share the profits also. Once the distributor has acquired the rights of the film, again, the process does not end there. There is a lot of promotional activity which has to be undergone for the film. Like, you know, you have teasers, you have first looks, you have motion poster releases, you have audio launches. All this involves a lot of money, and this attracts the audience to get to watch the film. So there are a lot of promotion and marketing activities that happen before the release of the film. And finally, the final print will be arrived at, which is given to the audience, which is sent to the audience for public exhibition, like in the cinema theaters or in OTT platforms. So before a film is released, it is not easy to, you know, comment saying that, okay, why is the film not yet released? What happened? The film would have been produced and kept ready, but then it would have not hit the screens, because there are all these processes that has to happen. There are a lot of legal formalities which has to the film has to undergo in order for the film to be finally released to the audience. So before we say a film is good or bad, let's think of the process which goes behind the production of the film. So once finally everything is done, the film hits the theaters and you get to watch it on the theaters or on your OTT platforms comfortably and enjoy the film. So this is what happens behind the production of the film. Thank you. I hope you understood the various steps that happen in the filmmaking production process.